Today we're recovering remains of a mastodon, apparently brought to a lake, and we think stored in this lake as a strategy for meat storage by early humans who lived in this part of the world at that same time.
2 years ago, I was here with some students from the Fowler Center, and we were walking in the ditch looking for fish, and we saw this bone laying in the water. We thought it was interesting. One of my students picked it up, and we found out that it was the tibia of a mastodon. This is really a dream come true for me. When I was a kid, I wanted to be a paleontologist and have always been on the lookout for stuff. So this is the find of a lifetime for me.
This is the ulna.
The Fowler Center of Outdoor Learning is the landowner of this property. We mutually decided to involve local school teachers in the project.
We spend most of our time teaching in the historic period when there was written language. But it's really important, I think, to teach before that also, because there's a long history before that, and we only know that through research.
Finding a specimen like this also tells us something that's important about human history. What did it take to feed a family, to raise a family? What did it take to make a life in early Michigan, soon after the recession of the ice, at the end of the ice age?
And we've had over 900 people through just in the past 3 days. The word's really gotten out, and it's brought people together to have the opportunity to be part of the research and the dig.
We were using
two of the other bones are called the thyrohyoids, and there's one basehyoid, and those are in the base of the tongue. In the olden days, tongue was pretty good stuff. It's solid meat, it's sort of marbled with fat, it's very nutritious, it's a good thing, and they often would butcher the tongue.
What excites me about it, and excites me in the classroom, and I hope it does my students also, is that on this very spot, there was life happening 10,000 years ago. There was life happening 5,000 years ago. There were people having families here, and teenage kids and little kids, you know, 10,000 years ago, and trying to survive like we are right in this place. History didn't start here 200 years ago.